In this lesson, we will continue to use polygon modeling tools to refine the lamp we started with primitives from a previous lesson. We're going to refine the lamp to look more like this one. Start by opening the basic lamp 001 that we created in an earlier lesson. The main change we'll make will be to the head of the lamp, but we'll start with the base. Turn on edge faces using the shortcut F4. Select the lamp base object. In the Modeling ribbon, Polygon Panel, convert the object to an editable polygon. Enter Edge Mode and use Ctrl-click to select the four edges at the top of the lamp base object. In the ribbon, Edges panel, go to the chamfer settings to bring up the caddy. Change the edge chamfer amount to 2 and the connect edge segments to 5. Okay the caddy. This gives the lamp base a nice beveled edge. Exit edge mode by clicking on the edge button again. Select the lamp main object. Convert to poly as we've done before, and then enter polygon mode. Select the end cap polygon and delete it. Now change to border mode. The border mode is the edge around a hole. We are going to extrude, but instead of using the tool, we'll use the shift and move method. Make sure the move tool is selected. Hold shift and drag the border to about here. Use the shortcut key R to access scale and scale the border up approximately 350%. You can do this by watching the scale amount in the transform typeins at the bottom of your interface. Then switch to the rotate tool with the keyboard shortcut E. Rotate negative 45 degrees. Now, using the move tool, shortcut is W, move the border down so the top edge is straight with the main part of the lamp. The transition between the two lamp main parts is too hard. To soften it, we'll use chamfer. Switch to edge mode and select the edges at the middle portion of the lamp. Because this is a loop selection, you can just double-click on one edge and the remaining edges will be selected. In the ribbon, Edges panel, open the chamfer settings. Change the chamfer amount to 0.5 and the connect edges segments to 3. Then OK the caddy. Repeat the same on the end cap, but this time select a single edge, then go to the ribbon, modify selection panel, and select the arrow next to loop and choose loop cylinder end. We did it this way because the double-click shortcut for looping does not work for end caps. Open the chamfer settings. Change the chamfer amount to 0.25 and the connect edge segments to 3. Now OK the caddy. Exit edge mode by selecting the edge icon in the ribbon. Now go to the modify panel and from the modifier list, add the shell modifier. Change the inner amount to 0.1 and the outer amount to 0. This gives the lamp some thickness and makes it so it renders properly. The lamppost needs just a bit of detail where it meets the lamp base. Select the cylinder and convert it to poly. In the ribbon, Edit panel, select Swift Loop and place a loop a bit above where the post meets the base. Enter polygon mode and select the polygons between the new edge and the base. Open the extrude settings to access the caddy and change the extrude type to local normal. Now change the amount to 0.5. Switch to edge mode. You can just double-click on one edge and select the top edges of the extruded polygons. In the ribbon, Edge panel, open the chamfer settings. keep the amount at 1.0. Change the connect edges segments to 6 and OK the caddy. Save the file. Now, open the train station file. Go to the file, import merge, and then select the basic lamp 001 file that we saved after refining the model. And then from the dialog box, choose the three objects that make up the lamp. The easiest way to move the objects around is to group them. With the parts of the lamp still selected, go to the main menu, group, and then choose group. Name it lamp 001. A group combines two or more objects into a single grouped object. Use the transform typeins. First select the move tool, then change X to 860, Y to negative 220, Z to 280. Navigate to find the lamp inside the station. Then switch to the rotate tool. Change the X to negative 90 and Y to negative 90. Leave Z at 0. Once the lamp was in the train station, I felt like it was a bit big, so switch to the scale tool and scale down to 70%. I also felt like that the wall could use two lamps, so with the move tool, hold shift and move over the next seat on the screen right. When the clone option opens, choose instance. Now select both lamps and change their color to black. Last thing we need to do is to make a layer for the lamps in the Scene Explorer. Make sure the Scene Explorer is set to Sort by Layer. Select all the lamp objects in the Scene Explorer and then select the Create New Layer button. Rename the layer to Lamps. Now save this train station file to use on the next lesson.